Have you ever left something at home open or turned on for a long time, like a front door lock, garage door, fridge door, or maybe iron? I have. That's why I started using Home Assistant Alert. It sends me repeated notifications at customizable intervals, so I never forget again. On top, these notifications can be actionable. That means I can tap on the notification and I can close my garage door, or I can ignore if I want my door to remain open until the next automatic reminder. I'll first show you how a Home Assistant Alert functionality is working end-to-end for me, and then I'll show you how I did everything. This is my test Home Assistant, and as you can see right here, I have two alerts configured. One of them is monitoring for my garage door. Is it open? Is it closed? And if it stays open for some period of time, it will become active alert. So I will demonstrate to that first, then I'll explain later. I'll open my garage door, and you see that this alert will become on in just a few seconds after the garage is open. Now the garage door is open, and this alert is now on. It becomes from idle to on. That means currently the alert is active. And after 1 minute, I'll receive a notification because I configured my system that way. So if the garage door stays open for 1 minute, I'll receive a notification. And you'll see that in just a few seconds. The alerts can have three states: idle, which means the condition of the alert is false, on, the condition of the alert is true, and off, the condition for the alert is true, but it was acknowledged. And I just received a text on my phone from the companion app. I'm not sure, is it visible? And also from the Telegram messenger. I'll show you the Telegram window now. And inside this Telegram window, I have a message saying the garage door is still open, and I have two buttons, close garage and acknowledge. If I click on acknowledge, the alert will become off. And again, that means the condition for the alert is true, the garage is still open, but I acknowledge that, I know about that. And I click on acknowledge. But if I open my Telegram again and if I click on close garage, the garage, I receive this message, the garage is closing, and indeed the garage is going to be closed. And my alert is now in idle state again. So this is one of the use cases. The next one is this front door battery is low. This is actually a template binary sensor. If I go to my helpers, I'll show you quickly. Helpers. This is my template sensor, and these are the template options. It gets the state of my front door battery, and if the state is below 15%, this sensor will be on, or it will have a state of true. And because currently the state of this sensor is 90%, this is false, and respectively the sensor is off. But if I change this to 95, for example, you can see that this is on now. And if I click on submit to update the template, you see that the state of this template sensor is immediately changed. And if I go back to my overview section, my dashboard, you also see that this front door battery is low alert is now on. It becomes from idle to on. And because I have few automations that I'll show you in just a minute, after 1 minute in this state, I'll receive a message again in my Telegram. Here it is, the front door battery is still low. The front door battery is still low, and I can acknowledge that or I can leave it. If I leave it, I'll receive another reminder in the predefined by me time. For example, in this case, after 1 more minute. Now let me show you how I did everything. To configure Home Assistant Alert, you have to get your hands a bit dirty. I mean, there is no fancy graphical user interface for that yet. And you have to add a bit of configuration in your configuration.yaml file. But don't worry, most of it is just copy and pasting. If you have Home Assistant OS or supervised, you can use add-ons like File Editor or VS Code. These add-ons can be installed with one click from the add-on store, and you can edit text file using them inside your browser. On the other hand, if you are a Home Assistant container or core user, you will not have add-ons and you have to find and edit your Home Assistant configuration files on your file system, which is not that hard, but it is different. If you are a bit confused from all these Home Assistant OS, supervised, core and container terms, don't worry, just register for my Home Assistant webinar and you will understand everything essential in no time, absolutely for free. You can use the link in the video description or you can scan the QR code to reserve your seat. Here is how the very basic Home Assistant alert can be configured. I used File Editor add-on to edit my configuration.yaml file. This add-on is available in the add-on store as one-click install. You can use VS Code with the same success, or if you don't have add-on store, you have to find your configuration.yaml file and you have to edit it. And here I added this section. From here to here, I describe my garage door alert. And these are the important things. The name can be whatever you wish. The message that I will receive when this alert becomes active. The done message, I'll receive this message when the alert is cleared or the condition of this alert is changed. For example, the garage door is now closed. The entity ID. Here I'm saying which entity or device will be monitored. In my case, cover.garageDoor. This is my garage door. And if the state becomes open, this is the state of the entity that I want to track. That means if the state of the cover.garageDoor is open for 1 minute, because I said that in here in this repeat section, activate this alert. And this option here is optional, default is true. I can acknowledge this alert like I showed you, and I can skip the first notification. This means I'll not receive the first message. Immediately after the garage is open, I'll not receive anything. But if this is set to false, when you open your garage, for example, I'll receive this message. The garage door is still open. And after that, I have this data inline keyboard with few options, with two options, close garage and send this callback message and acknowledge and send this garage acknowledge message. This is valid for the Telegram Messenger. If you follow my video tutorial or the official Telegram integration documentation inside Home Assistant, where you can add Telegram as a notification service, like I did here in this section, and here also Telegram bot and notify section. You just have to create a new bot from Telegram. Then you have to get the chat ID, and then you have to get the API key and you have to paste them all in your configuration.yaml. And after that, you can use Telegram for notification service from Home Assistant. It can send messages to your phone, desktop or whatever. And I'm using exactly that. And back to this section, Telegram allows to have inline keyboard. And this keyboard is what you saw in the beginning, these buttons. And these buttons can be defined here. This is the text of the button, and this is the callback message that will be returned if you press on this button. Same here, this will be the text on the next button, and this will be the callback message. I'm using these callback messages in my automations, as you'll see in a few seconds. And finally, I have notifier section, where I added this app and Telegram, which is actually a group defined here. This is the name of the group and this is the services. These are my notify.mobile app, Kirill service, which is my Home Assistant companion app. And this is the notify.telegram service described here. So that using that group, I can combine two or more messengers. I can also add few more parameters as described here in the Home Assistant alert documentation. Where it is? Group. Here it is actually. If you're using Twilio SMS, for example, notification service, which requires a target phone, you can define this as a group and you can name this group whatever you wish, and then you can use only this group within notifiers. Because you cannot define any additional data and targets here, you're using this group functionality to achieve this, which is very clever. Back to my examples, the next alert is this front door battery. The name again can be anything, the message is this one that I will receive if the condition is met and if the alert is active. If the condition is cleared, that means if I change the battery and the battery is above the defined threshold, I'll receive this message. This is the monitored entity ID. This is my binary sensor, which is actually my template sensor that I showed you before. And this is interesting. You can define here dynamic repeats. That means this alert will be repeated and I'll receive message on the first minute, then on the third minute, then on minute 5, and after that, after every 24 hours. Again, this alert can be acknowledged, and this time keep first is false. That means immediately after this alert becomes active or on, I'll receive a message. After that, on the first minute, third minute, and so on and so forth. Again, I have inline keyboard with one button acknowledge, where I can press on this acknowledge button and I'll say to Home Assistant, okay, the battery is low, but I know that and I'll change it when I have enough time for that. Again, the notifier is this group that I defined here under my notify section. With the same success, I can only type here this one. Or this one. And this one. And I'll receive again messages to my companion app, Home Assistant companion app, and on my Telegram. So this group and these notify services will do the same job. But again, if you want to add few more parameters to these services, you should use a group. One more important remark here, after you add these alert sections in your configuration.yaml, you have to save the changes, then you have to check the configuration if everything is fine, and you have to restart your Home Assistant so these alerts to become active. I'll open my automation sections to show you which automations I'm using. I'm using two automations. The first one is Telegram callback to close the garage door. I'm using this automation to catch the callback buttons from the inline keyboard and to do some action. Let me show you. This is the trigger. The trigger is event type, and this is the exact trigger that I'm listening for. And if this event is having this data, close garage, which I defined here in the inline keyboard, the automations will be activated. And as actions, I have two actions actually. This is the most important one. It will simply close my garage. The second one, this one, actually the first one here in this order, is not so important. It is actually using the Telegram bot answer callback query, which will return me some messages inside Telegram. And probably you saw that during my tests. I'll show you again. I'll open the overview section of my Home Assistant and I have to go through the whole process again, but I'll leave that open and I'll continue describing and explaining. Basically, that's it. I'm listening for close garage callback section in the Telegram callback event. And if this happens, if I receive this event, I'm closing my garage as usual with the cover close service, and this I can delete it. It is not important. It is just for additional pop-up that I'm receiving inside Telegram. And the other action automation is for the acknowledge. Same thing, but different data, event data. If I receive Telegram callback event, and if this event is having this data, garage acknowledge, as described here, garage acknowledge. The automation will be activated and it will invoke this service alert, turn off, and as entity, I'm choosing my alert. I'm going to delete this to show you better. Now I have two alerts, alert.garage, alert.garageDoor, and alert.frontDoorBattery. And I just have to select mine, and that's it. I just received the garage open notification in my Telegram, and I want to show you what I was talking about. I'll go back in the previous automation. I wanted to show you this section, this action. Telegram bot answer callback query. Show alert true, and I have some target and callback query IDs and a message. And now, if I click on close garage, I receive this pop-up. It is entirely optional. You can delete entirely this action and you'll find my configuration, this automation and the alert section under the video in the video description, so you don't try to remember anything from here. Just copy and paste and adapt to your needs. It's that simple. The other interesting things that I want to mention is the following. You can use templates in the message as shown here. This will send a dynamic message which will also share the alert, the problem. In this example, plant office needs help, moisture is low. You can use the Home Assistant companion app on your phone to do the same instead of Telegram. You have to tag your alert and then you have to use replacing and clearing options and actionable notifications that are possible with the Home Assistant companion app as described here. But have in mind that there are specific things for iOS and Android. I didn't try that end to end, but I believe it is possible and you can use Home Assistant companion app. But Telegram is working great. You can try it. Thank you for staying alert with me. And if you want to watch something else, check this one. Bye.